जी
थैंक यू सर सर आई स्टैंड हियर एंड थैंक द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर ब्रिंगिंग दिस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिल टू पार्लियामेंट टुडे एंड आईड लाइक टू कंग्रेचुलेट माई कॉलीग काकोली घोष हु हैज आउटडन हरसेल्फ इन हर स्पीच टुडे इट वॉज रियली वन ऑफ द फाइनेस्ट स्पीचेस वी हैव हर्ड इन पार्लियामेंट आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम वेरी पेशेंटली हर्ड बाय एवरीबडी माई कॉलीग संगीता आजाद हु इज नॉट अ डॉक्टर My colleague Karthi Chidambaram and Dr. Satyavati, who herself is an MD, have thrown a lot of light on a very serious subject. Sir, I am not a doctor, but I do understand the trauma a couple goes through. I was just talking to my friend Kanimozi about the same thing, that when such a bill comes, it really makes you introspect and think about your life, that something which comes so easily to millions of women, there is a cross-section of couples or human beings who have such difficulty in having a child. And I think having a child is one of the most happiest moments for any woman in this world. So I congratulate the Honorable Minister for bringing in this bill. But I just would like to ask him a few questions and a suggestions in this very wonderful, highly, one of the finest debates where I think we've all learned something new today. I would like to ask the Honorable Minister that the surrogacy bill and this bill, how are they going to complement each other? Because there was one big point which I think everybody has said, which I would like to highlight. I'm not going to repeat any points which everybody has made earlier, which are all very valid, is that we all feel that besides the couples who want the children, there are a cross-section of single people in this country today who want to have children, especially the LGBTQ community and a single father, which I think Karthi Chidambaram talked about. To which Hina Gavit clarified that because of the 2007 adoption rule, single men cannot have adopt a girl, and because they cannot adopt a girl, they cannot have this, they cannot avail to this bill. I think this is something we as a society need to introspect. Just because he's a man, I agree, I think we'll have to talk to the Women and Child Minister. I'd request the Honorable Minister to speak to the Women and Child Ministry. Maybe a lot of us can also help and contribute and work out a discussion, extend this, but I think we should not deprive any human being who deserves or wants to have a child. So I think just to leave any man out, just because there are some adoption rules, rules are made by all of us. And they have to be inclusive. That's the beauty of legislation. So why don't we all put all the bright minds, take technical people who have worked on this and see how we can make sure everybody can make use of all the legislations that we make, this being one of the most important ones. Another suggestion which I had to the Honorable Minister, who's so patiently listening to us, is what Kakoli Ghosh said, that it's really the timing of the bill. It's, I mean, the horse before the cart or the cart before the horse, this is what it has happened. But I think we must expedite this and make sure that the bill which is pending in Rajya Sabha is moved so that we integrate the two bills and you can implement them and make sure it's implemented flawlessly in this country. I would like to ask the Honorable Minister that Kakoli Ghosh extensively talked about the technicality of people who will be on the committee. I propose with the permission of all my colleagues that why don't you start with Parliament? There is Satyavati ji and there is Kakoli who are so qualified. So why don't Parliament promote such people who genuinely want to do something and who have done things on the field? It's not that the first time. Hina is also a doctor, so they can choose and make sure that this committee that is doing has had people who are working on the field. I have nothing against. Wonderful, there should be secretaries. For what even I think Dr. Kakoli Ghosh said, that we have no objections of secretaries being there, but then if the secretary who's going to be there has to be highly qualified, like my friends Dr. Satyavati and Dr. Kakoli and Dr. Hina. So I think that committee has to be very, very critical because it's here, it's not just, I mean, if I'm put on the committee, I'm not sure I'd be able to contribute like all these women who are qualified to do it. So I think that's going to be very, very important of how to get this committee going. I would like to highlight one more question to the Honorable Minister, that there is a pre-implementation genetic testing. Now, will you be allowing this? Now, the technical part of pre-genetic, pre-implementation genetic testing is, this is not for sex determination, but it is for disease determination. So what is the government's line? Or what would the Mantralaya would like to propose, that if we get this testing done for any child, or any parent, they do not really want to give birth to a child who could be deformed, because the life of the parent and the child is not necessarily good. We don't even know how long the child will live. Normally, it would be either Down syndrome or epilepsy, cerebral palsy. There are so many issues parents go through. So is there a chance that we could add this as an extension? I think I'd even like Kakoli Ghosh and Satyavati ji to throw light on this later on and tell us and explain to us whether this kind of technology, because this bill seems to be silent on disease control. So can you guide us on how we can take this forward? The other, I think, is the clinic, the technicians, everybody's spoken extensively about it. But I think to make this affordable to all, why don't you give it as a project to every state and give a target to every state? Because we'll first have to skill workers to do this, because from whatever I understand from Dr. Kakoli Ghosh's speech, that this is a highly technical, skilled job to do this. So there are a lot of times, even in government hospitals, we don't get people even to do simple sonographies. So if we don't have technicians for a simple sonography, how are we going to expand the ART is my big question. So is the government doing something through the skill development department to make sure we push this as an agenda, as a top priority program for any government, whether it's our state or your state or in the country? And I think, why don't you take the help? Because FOXI has written to you, which is all the gynecologists get together. They have a great organization in India. Because there is, I think, the fear right now in a lot of the doctors is the, what happens is the kind of penalization done to them. It's 5 years in jail, 10 years in jail. I think the COVID has taught all of us that the entire medical fraternity has exceptionally delivered, actually outdone themselves during the COVID. So why are we looking at only putting everybody in jail? Jail is not the solution. I think what we, and doctors are not criminals. They've proved to be God right now in India. In COVID, who has saved our life? The administration, who has worked overtime, and all the doctors who have, and all the medical workers who have worked so hard during this COVID, during this pandemic. So I urge the Honorable Ministry that why don't we find a way of just putting all our doctors in jail may not be. Why don't you take help from the IMA or FOXI or all such organizations instead of criminalizing the doctors? Is there not a way where their institute, which is the IMA or the FOXI, who can punish the doctor instead of we punishing and putting them in jail? I don't think really that putting them in jail is going to be a solution. So I think this is something which you must talk to all the doctors. I think your MOS is also a doctor, Bharti Thai. Why don't you ask her to talk to the fraternity and see what is this? Sanjay is also a doctor, Sanjay Bhai sitting here. So I'm sure they will agree with what I'm saying. This is not about you versus us, but this is a more larger social goal we have to reach. We have to make sure that the doctors in this country feel very secure and safe and reassured, because we can't threaten doctors. So this is a very good project that you all are doing, but I feel technically I'm not sure if India's really ready and sound, and I'd urge the Honorable Minister in his reply to see how we as states can work better with you to improve the situation of all the women and the lives of becoming a mother. Just one last line I would like to read. The lady Geeta Aramvetam, an award-winning journalist, said about a book that she said about baby makers, the story of India's surrogacy. I think to quote her, she said, the constitution gives a woman a right to reproduce or not to reproduce as she wishes. And she has the right to privacy when she makes her reproductive choices. So this has to be incorporated in the bill. If I have the right to reproduce, I mean I can hire a surrogate, I can go in for IVF, whether I'm a transgender, a lesbian or a divorcee, I have this right as I wish. This is a woman who has lent her womb, has all these rights. So I request you to be considering, this is not a gender issue, this is a social issue, and I think sometimes some things have to be dealt with the heart. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Supriya ji. Sri Anubhav Mohante ji.
Thank you so much, sir. Aapne mujhe mauka diya is gambhir vishay par bolne ka. Sir, main shuru karunga jahan par maniya sadasya Supriya Sule ji ne khatam kiya. This is definitely not a gender issue. It's an issue for all of